Hi, and welcome to the FMOD Studio Getting Started tutorial series. In this video series, we'll be going through everything you need in order to get FMOD Studio up and running for your project, from installation all the way through to integration to your game engine. In this video, we'll be going over FMOD Studio's interface and its basic workflow. First, let's get FMOD Studio installed. When you load into fmod.com, you'll need to sign in or make an account to access the FMOD downloads. When you click sign in, you'll be prompted to enter your account details. If you haven't got an account yet, click register. Once you fill out your information here, your account will be ready to use. Just click sign in again and input your new details. If you then click download, you'll be taken to the downloads page. On the downloads page, you'll need to click the FMOD Studio option. Under FMOD Studio, select your version, then download the correct package for your system. Note that we want FMOD Studio, not FMOD Engine. FMOD Studio is the software tool used to create sounds for your game, whereas FMOD Engine is designed for programmers who want to integrate the FMOD code into the game engine. Once your download finishes, run the installer, then open your newly installed FMOD Studio. When you open FMOD Studio, you'll be shown the welcome dialog. From here, you can view the latest release notes, as well as a detailed release history. You can also view the user manual and quick start tutorial documentation. And any recent project that you've opened in this version of FMOD Studio will also show up here. For now, we just want to start a new project to familiarize ourselves, so we'll click New Project. First, let's save our project. This is an important step, as FMOD Studio will automatically create a series of subfolders and link them to your FMOD Studio project. Just navigate to File, then click Save, or click Ctrl and S on Windows, or Command and S on Mac. From here, choose where you want to save your project, give your project a name, and click Save. Now we're ready to start adding sound files to FMOD Studio. First, let's look at the three tabs you'll spend the most time with. The Assets tab is where any file you load into FMOD will be stored. You simply drag your audio file, either one at a time or multiples at once, directly into the Asset tab. Once the file has been imported into FMOD Studio, you can select the file name and view advanced details in the panel below. You can preview a sound by clicking the play button in this area. Back in the Assets tab, you can create folders in order to better organize your audio files. You can select View in Explorer on Windows or in Finder on Mac to view where the file is being stored on your hard drive. Any folders you add in FMOD Studio will be reflected there as well. The Events tab is where all of FMOD Studio's events are stored. An event in FMOD Studio is a unit of sound that can be played, controlled, and stopped from inside the game engine. One way to think about events is that they are somewhat like a project for your DAW or audio creation software. Each event in FMOD Studio can have multiple tracks of audio, multiple effects, and even custom track output routing. There are certain limitations to their similarity to DAW projects, however, which we'll cover later in this video. For now, just think of it like this. In FMOD Studio, you create an event, play a sound. You can then customize how that sound will be played within each event. A game engine can then play that event just as it would a normal audio clip, but now the sound played retains all of your customizations. If you right-click in the Events tab, you can either create a blank event or select one of our pre-made events here. For now, let's select 3D Timeline and name the new event Test Event. This will create an event with a timeline sheet ready to play 2D sounds. We'll cover sheets and 2D versus 3D audio in a future video, so for now, let's focus on adding some sounds to this event. If you navigate back to the Assets tab, you can select the sounds you want to add and drag them into the timeline. FMOD Studio will automatically detect if you want to use a single or multi-instrument this way, and set up the instrument ready to be played, with the track routed automatically to the master track. To play an event, you can either press spacebar or use controls in the transport bar here. You can, of course, set up instruments manually, but we'll cover that in our next video. The Banks tab is where all created banks are stored for your project. A bank is a collection of events and assets from your FMOD Studio project, exported in a way that your game engine can access. FMOD will automatically create a master bank for you, so for now we'll just use this one. To assign an event to this bank, simply right-click the event, select Assign to Bank, browse, then select Master. To recap, think of the flow of data like this. We load sound files into the Assets tab. Those assets get used by specific events. The events then contain information as to how those sounds are played. When you assign events to specific banks, they can be loaded in and out of the game engine as needed. It's a similar process to creating a sound in your DAW. You load the sound from a folder on your hard drive into a project in your DAW. In your DAW, you manipulate the sound as needed, then export the changes as a new sound file, which you can open and play whenever you need. Next, we'll look at the deck, where you can find the properties of each selected event or instrument. Most items within FMOD Studio have their own properties. Just select an item, and you'll see the properties of that item in the deck. We'll go into more details here in a later video. For now, just remember to always check what name is being displayed here, as it will update to show you what you have selected. You can imagine instrument properties are applied in between events and banks in the flow of data. When a game engine plays an event, it checks if the assigned bank has been loaded. If so, it will try to find the event in that bank. If the game engine finds that event will be played. The event then checks the properties of the included instruments as well as any customization we mentioned before. Finally, the event plays the sound. With these concepts in mind, you'll have a strong foundation in working with FMOD Studio in the future. Stay tuned for our next video, where we will be covering the different types of events FMOD Studio uses to play audio. Thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to keep up to date on all our new videos.